children in America are counting.
I want to count backwards.
One.
Two potatoes, three potatoes, four.
Five, six.
Children in Egypt are counting. Children in South Africa are counting.
One, two, three, four.
Children in China are counting. Children in Russia are counting. Children in 120 countries are counting on you. Sesame Workshop puts the proceeds it receives from the sales of its products right back into Sesame Street and other local educational projects for children worldwide. So you did more than just buy a video or attend a performance. You helped educate children around the world.
Thank you.
Learn more at sesameworkshop.org.
Street. All right, Elmo, it's your turn. Go ahead. Elmo? What's the matter? You okay?
Huh? Oh, yeah, sure, Gina. Elmo's feeling...
Elmo? Elmo, honey, it's really important for you to tell me if you're not feeling well, okay? So is that what's the matter? Are you feeling sick?
Elmo doesn't feel too good, Gina.
No, what's the matter? Does your tummy hurt? What?
No.
No, not your tummy? Well, I see you scratching your ear. Is that what's the matter? Look, tell me exactly how you're feeling.
Okay, Gina. Elmo woke up this morning and his ear felt so bad. Elmo woke up this morning and his ear felt so bad.
You start feeling like this? This morning or when we were playing? When?
Well, Elmo's ear started hurting this morning, but now it really, really hurts.
Oh, well, honey, if it really hurts this bad, we should probably go see a doctor.
Doctor?
What you doing down there?
Yeah.
Playing hide and seek?
Oh, no. See, Elmo has an earache, and he's a little bit frightened to go to the doctor.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, Elmo, you don't have to be scared. The doctor is your friend. Well, how are you supposed to know that?
Because I've been to the doctor, and so have you, Elmo. Here, Baker and I will show you, okay? I'll be the doctor.
Yes, and I'll be the nurse. Hello, Elmo. I'm Nurse Big Bird.
Nurse Big Bird?
Dr. Rosita, we'll see you now.
Oh, that's me. Hola, my little red friend Munster. I will now examine you to find out why are you sick. Okay. First, stick out your tongue and say, Very good. Yeah. Now, little monster, watch this finger really closely. All right? Follow my finger.
See, Elmo, it's not that scary. How's your ear feeling?
It still really hurts, Gina.
Oh, then you know what? We should really have a doctor take a look at it, okay? She'll figure out what to do to make you feel better.
Elmo, here. You can take Radar. He's been to the doctor lots of times with me.
Oh, thank you, Big Bird.
It's okay.
And thanks, Rosita, for helping Elmo not be so scared.
Oh, no problem, Elmo. I hope you feel better.
Oh,
okay. Thanks, Rosita.
Come on, let's go. It's gonna be fine.
Okay.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye. You'll be okay.
Bye.
Oh, Mrs. McGillicuddy,
you and your son just have a seat. Doctor will be right with you.
Oh, thank you, nurse. Okay, come on, dear. Let's walk
over
here. Oh, look, there's a play table.
Okay.
There's a horse
and a chicken.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, look,
so how long
has
it been?
Hey,
Gina.
Hey,
Susan. Hey, Elmo.
I'm
feeling sick, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, Doctor, I'll see you really soon. Come right on in. Come on.
Hey, look, that's Ernie and Bert.
Yeah.
No, we're not, Ernie. That's one thing.
Sorry, Bert.
Oh, look, and there's Baby Bear.
Yeah, go talk to Baby Bear. That's good.
Okay. Hi, Baby Bear.
Oh, hi, Elmo.
What are you doing here?
I got a really bad sore throat.
He sure does.
Yeah, and Bert has a bad cold.
Yeah, what are you doing?
I think Bert wants to know why you're here, Elmo.
Yeah.
Elmo's ear really hurts bad.
I've got a boo-boo on my beak.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm a horse.
And every time he takes a breath, he sneezes.
Achoo!
And I slipped and rubbed my claw.
I tripped and hurt my paw.
Doctor, hurry up and see us, please.
Achoo!
My trunk is all stuffed up.
This morning I threw up.
I just coughed for the 100th time today.
My antler's really sore. I can't take it anymore.
Doc, you gotta see us right away.
That's 101 course.
I've got one upset tummy, and my hoof is feeling crummy.
And this throbbing in his forehead's getting stronger. Oh dear.
Got an ache in Elmo's ear, and that's why Elmo's here.
Doctor, please, we can't wait any longer.
Bert, you're next.
And this fever's got my goat.
And a hornache's made me one unhappy cow.
I feel out of sorts and drowsy.
We're sick of feeling lousy. Doctor, please, we gotta see you now.
Baby Bear, you're next.
Doctor, please, we wanna get well now.
Elmo, you're next. There you go.
Thank you, Gina.
Let me look at it. Doctor. Okay, I am sure the doctor will be here. Elmo?
So how long have you been feeling sick, Bert?
One week.
Oh, any stomach pain, Bert?
No.
But a lot of coughing. Yes, and sneezing.
Yes.
Yes.
Choose, Elmo. Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, anyway, Bert, it looks like you definitely have a bad cold.
Bert, you definitely have a bad cold.
Yes. Now, what you need to do, Bert, is drink plenty of liquids.
Drink plenty of liquids, Bert.
Yes, and get lots and lots of rest.
Lots and lots of rest, Bert.
Yes, you'll feel better in just a few days.
You'll feel better in just a few days.
I know what's inside, are they?
Well, I'm just trying to help, Bert.
Yes, he's just trying to help, Bert.
Excuse me? Hi, have any of you seen Elmo?
Yeah.
He went that way.
Thank you, Bert.
You're welcome. Here you go, Bert.
Yes.
Here you go, buddy.
All righty then, just open wide and say ah. Dearie me.
Sorry.
Well then, open wide and say ba. Close enough.
So, what seems to be the problem?
Well, you see, Doctor, Baby Bear had one of those strep throats last year. So when his throat real sore, we came right on in.
Well, good thinking. Now, what
hey,
I think...
Excuse me, did any of you see Elmo run by here?
No, Gina, haven't seen him.
Now, young bear, remember last time I took this stick and I touched it on your throat? Well, we're just gonna have to do that again.
Wait a minute! You're gonna put that stick in Baby Bear's throat? Mm-hmm. Aren't you scared, Baby Bear?
Well, yeah, a wee little bit.
Oh, now hold on there, Baby Bear. It'll be fine. Listen, we'll just count 1, 2, 3, and it'll be all over. Okay, son?
Okay. Ready when you are, Doc.
Okay, Baby Bear. Say,
One, two, three.
All done.
Yay! Aw,
that's my boy. I'm so proud of you, Baby Bear.
Wow. Are you okay, Baby Bear? Did it hurt?
Well, it felt a wee bit funny, but it was over really quick.
Well, it looks like strep throat, but we'll know in a few minutes. Now, if it is, Baby Bear, you'll be fine once you take some medicine. It'll make you feel better very soon. But you should take it whenever Papa Bear here gives it to you until all the medicine is gone. Okay, Baby Bear?
No problem, Doc.
Thanks, Doctor.
Hey, you're welcome.
Yeah. Wow. Gina?
Yeah?
Elmo wants to see the doctor now, so Elmo can feel better, too. Elmo's ear hurts.
Okay, come on, you. We are going to see the doctor, and you are going to feel so much better.
All right.
So, Elmo, let's find out why that ear of yours is hurting so much.
Well, what's that for?
Well, I'll show you. Here, we're going to put these in your ears.
It's okay.
It's not going to hurt at all. Okay. And, Elmo, you're going to hear something. Listen.
Okay. Elmo hears thump, 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 thump.
That's my heartbeat. And now I am going to listen to yours. I will put this in my ear and put this there.
Still cold.
Just a little bit. Now breathe deep. Anything else bothering you, Elmo? Is your nose stuffy?
Elmo's body hurts.
Do you feel hot, Elmo? Yeah, does it hurt down here in your tummy?
No, that tickles.
Okay, Elmo, let's check out your little piggies here. Got this little piggy and this little piggy. Oh, wait, hold that pose. Good. Now let's look at that ear, Elmo.
Okay,
now turn this way. Gonna look inside your ear. Well, Elmo, the reason why your ear hurts so much is because you have an ear infection. Looks kind of red and swollen in there, and that's how I can tell. But it's nothing to worry about. We can take care of it with a little medicine called an antibiotic, okay?
Antibiotic?
You did so great, Elmo. I am so proud of you.
Thank you, Gina.
Okay.
What do you mean, that's it?
Well, that's almost it, Elmo. Okay, write this out. Now, he's going to need to take this medicine until it is all gone.
Okay.
Even if he starts to feel better. Okay, Elmo?
Okay. Is the medicine going to taste yucky?
Well, actually, it tastes pretty good. But you should never take it unless given to you by a grown-up.
Oh, okay.
Now, there's only one thing left to do.
Oh, no.
Okay.
What's the doctor going to do?
Okay, Elmo.
Oh, no.
Elmo, look inside and pick one.
Ah, stickers! Mm-hmm. Yay!
Yeah.
Oh, Elmo wants some. The rainbow!
Okay, we can give you a rainbow right here.
Ah.
And I promise you, in a few days, you will be feeling much better.
Oh, thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome, Elmo.
I love it.
What a handsome sticker for a very handsome monster.
Come on, everybody, let's go to the opera! Yay! Let's go!
Look at Elmo. Wow, he looks all better now.
I don't want you to get a chilbert.
Annie,
keep you nice and warm.
Annie, I don't need a blanket. My coat's all gone.
Can't take any chances, Bert.
Come on. Hey, Elmo, wait up.
Hold on just a minute there, son of mine. You have to take your medicine.
Do I have to? I feel so much better.
Don't you remember what the doctor said, son? You have to take your medicine every day until it's finished, even if you're feeling better.
Okay, Papa Bear.
There you go.
Yummy, yummy. Yeah, thanks, Papa Bear. Oh, here we go.
Thank you.
And thank you. Wait up, Elmo!
That's my boy.
Bye, everybody. Bye. Oh, look what the doctor gave Elmo.
What?
See, see, Big Bird?
Oh. Yeah, look, I got one, too.
Oh, wow, great stickers, you guys. Yeah, and Regina and Big Bird were right. Elmo didn't have to be scared about going to the doctor. She gave Elmo medicine to take until it was all gone. And in a few days, Elmo was better.
Water bottle.
Oh, Bert, just give it a try. Come on.
If you've got a fever, we'll help you to shake it.
If we give you medicine, make sure you take it.
And if you scrape your knee, so you can't stop that sneeze. People, we beg you, come visit us, please.
Cause keeping folks well is what we're here to do.
We did it for Elmo, we'll do it for you.
Shoo! Shoo! Oh, no!
Well, it's Radar.
Achoo! Don't worry, Radar. Elmo knows all about going to the doctor.
Yeah, they'll check your wee little throat.
Yeah, and your ears if they hurt.
Yeah, and you know, if you have to take medicine, remember, only take it when a grown-up gives it to you.
Yeah. Oh, that's right, yes.
Look, and soon you'll be feeling all better.
Pediatrician is a doctor who takes care of little kids.
Pediatrician.
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 I love my doctor.
I love my doctor.
My favorite doctor is Dr. Shapasso.
My doctor's name is
Dr. Horowitz.
Dr. K.
Dr. Orby.
I have lots of checkups.
Checkup, 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 checkup.
It's called a checkup because he checks up on me.
Taking their heads
eyes, nose, throat. When he looked in my ear, he'd say, there's a rabbit in my ear. No!
Ouch!
It doesn't hurt for me, but it hurts a lot for my big brother.
I like to give my doctor a checkup.
Stethoscope!
Stethoscope!
I hear my heart. Sounds pretty good to me.
There's a bunch of doctors.
An eye doctor.
A nose doctor.
A brain surgeon, a heart surgeon.
Don't be scared.
Don't be scared, because doctors don't bite.
I was never scared of the doctor.
I like to be a doctor.
Doctor?
My doctor makes me feel better.
I'm healthy.
Pediatrician.
When you go visit the doctor, he helps you stay healthy. But he can't do it without us. Hey, down here. No, a little lower. Hi there. I'm a Band-Aid, and I'm just one of a doctor's many, many helpers. Hey, come and meet my friends. This is Stethoscope.
Hi.
She's got a job that's near to your heart. Very near. Get it?
Ha ha. Oops, gotta get to work.
The doctor uses stethoscope to listen to your heart. How's it sounding, Steph?
Now that's a beat that can't be beat.
Moving right along, here's a friend who doesn't mind if you stick your tongue out at him. Ha! It's Tongue Depressor!
My job is anything but depressing.
He holds your tongue down so the doctor can get a good look in your throat. Ooh, now there's someone else I want you to meet. This is Needle. She gets a bad rap, but she's really here to help you.
That's right. Sometimes doctors use me to give you medicine. I might hurt a little, but I can really help you stay healthy.
She's got a point. Literally.
Ow. Hey, that wasn't so bad.
And when Needle's done with her job, that's when I get to work. I cover up your boo-boos to help them heal. I'll stick with you.
See, all better. Mwah.
Aw, gee. Thanks, Mom.
I'm Nurse Wendy, the school nurse, and this is my nurse's portrait.
She's friendly.
She takes care of us like a doctor, except for a school.
She's a nurse.
Don't touch it. How'd the dirt go in?
I don't know.
Okay, close your eye. Put your head all the way up. 2 seconds. Keep it closed. Now open it. Excellent. Done. Feel better.
When I hurt my leg, I went to Nurse Wendy and she helped me.
I see Nurse Wendy when I'm sick.
She helps you get better.
What happened?
If that hurt or if they get a scrape, she would probably know what to do.
What's hurting you?
My ear.
Let me see, which ear? It's a good idea to come to the nurse with any kind of earache, stomach ache,
headache,
any kind of sore or bleeding or scratch that needs to be cleaned. If your throat hurts.
Once I got that.
If your foot hurts, leg hurts, anything that hurts. Does it hurt here? Here? Whenever you're really feeling unlike yourself, you should come to see the school nurse just to see if it's the beginning of something or if it's something that we don't have to worry about. But it's always good to just check.
Thank you, Nurse Wendy.
There are lots of things that can make you sneeze. Some pepper, a cold, or allergies. But no matter the reason, everyone agrees that when you sneeze, cover it, please. Sneezing can make germs fly through the air and land on whomever is standing there. Then they might get sick, and that isn't fair. So cover your sneeze to show that you care. But how do I cover my sneeze, you may say? With my foot? With my cat? With my mom's cheese souffle? Well, don't you worry. We'll tell you the way to cover that sneeze so the germs won't stray. Some people cover a sneeze with their hand. It's better than nothing, but They don't understand that the next thing they touch gets their germs on it, and that's not exactly what they had planned. A tissue will do. A handkerchief, too. But if those aren't around, here's what you do. Cover your sneeze with your arm. Then those germs won't get away from you. Bless you.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
To become a flower, it takes a while to learn to read and spell. You can't become a grown-up in an hour. A sick body needs time to get well. You've got to be patient, to be a patient waiter and do what the doctors say. You've got to be patient, to be a patient, and when you're well, you can go out and play. You don't want to miss out, you want to have fun. But you must take it slow until the sickness is done. It's not easy to wait and stay inside all day. But when you get well, you can go out and play. You've got to be patient, to be a patient. Stay in bed, do what the doctors say. You've got to be patient, to be a patient, waiting for the sickness to be on its way. It may seem boring, may seem slow to you. For getting better, it's what you have to do. You do the same things over again all day. When you get better, you can go out and play. You've got to be patient, to be a patient. Stay in bed, do what the doctors say. You've got to be patient, to be a patient, waiting for the sickness to be on its way. You've got to be patient, to be a patient. You'll be feeling better each and every day. And if you are patient, a patient, patient, pretty soon you can go out and play.
Ernie, what are you doing?
Oh, hi, Bert.
Hi.
I'm listening to my heartbeat.
Oh, good.
See, I'm thinking of becoming a doctor, Bert.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's terrific.
And so I thought I would just do those things that doctors do.
Oh.
And, Bert, that's where you can help me.
How can I help you?
Well, Bert, see, you can pretend to be a patient, and I'll pretend to be the doctor, and I'll do all those things that a doctor does when he checks the patient to see if he's healthy.
Why? Do I look sick?
No, Bert. I just want to check and make sure you're healthy. Okay, Bert?
Oh, I see. You'll be the patient?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
Fine. Sure.
Okay. Open your mouth and say, ah.
Oh, okay. Ah. Ah.
Oh. Bert.
What? What is it? What? Tell me. I can take it. What?
It's dark in there, Bert. You have a dark throat, Bert.
Of course I have a dark throat.
Hmm. Open your mouth and say, ah, again. You do it very well, Bert.
So am I healthy?
Well, I don't know yet. Now I have to listen to your heart.
Oh, okay.
Bend down.
Bend down. My heart is not there.
It isn't?
Not. Will you please?
Oh, yes, I know. I
down
remember.
Here.
Over there, that's right.
What do you mean you remember? Of course you know. Will you stop that?
Oh, Bert. Okay,
what
Bert.
Are you doing?
You've got a good heartbeat going there, Bert.
It is good?
It's very heavy.
Oh,
it's very heavy.
Is that good
but
heavy?
But first I have to check your pulse.
My pulse? Why?
Your pulse. Just a second.
But
I have to check your pulse here. Where is it?
It's right there.
Wait a minute.
What? What's wrong? What? Wait a minute. What? Why?
Bert?
What? What?
Either you have no pulse or my watch is broken.
What?
That's an old joke.
A joke?
Okay. Wait, just a second. I'll feel it.
Please tell me.
Here's your pulse. Got it? Got it?
Got it?
Got it? It's going ba-doom, ba-doom, ba-doom. That's a cute little pulse you got there, Bert.
It's fine. It's cute.
Congratulations,
is it
Bert. Bert, your examination is all over. Congratulations.
Oh, then I'm healthy.
Well, I don't know, Bert.
See,
what do you mean? I'm not a doctor. You'd have to ask a doctor. But I'm not a doctor yet, Bert.
Well, when can you tell me if I'm healthy?
Not right this minute, can I tell you, Bert?
But when?
Well, later, Bert.
When later? When can you tell me?
Well, let's see. I have 8 years of grade school.
Yeah.
And 4 years of high school.
Yeah.
And 4 years of college.
Yeah.
And then I've got 4 years of doctor school.
Yeah.
And 1 year of internship.
Yeah.
And 2 years of residence.
Okay, fine. But after all that, then can you tell me, when can you tell me I'm healthy? When?
In about 23 years, Bert. Gee, Bert fainted. Is there a doctor in the house?
Hello there. Would you like to know how you're able to jump and run like that? It's your bones and muscles. Your bones support your whole body. That's your funny bone. Your muscles allow you to move your bones so that you can do all sorts of things, like walking and running. And feet help you jump and help you land safely. We use the bones and muscles in our hands to catch and to throw. Great shot! The calcium in milk keeps your bones strong and healthy. Running and jumping keeps your muscles strong.
Did you say jump?
My mom is gonna have a baby. We're going to the doctor for a checkup for my mom and a baby.
Come on in. Welcome. So how are you feeling?
I feel pretty good.
Jordan, you know what I'm gonna do now?
I think you're taking the blood pressure right now.
That's right. Looks good. What's next?
We have to measure my mom's tummy.
That's right. So, do you remember how big it was last time?
It was 99 or about 100 last time.
Mm-hmm. Getting bigger.
Wow.
That's great.
Last we hear the baby's heart beating.
Cool, huh?
Thank you. Don't be scared.
What do you think?
I can hear the heart.
It means the baby's healthy. Sounds good. Are you excited?
Yeah.
See you in 2 weeks. Bye.
Oh!
Hi, Elmo.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
I'm just passing by. I'm on my way to the doctor for a checkup.
Okay.
See you later.
Bye, Big Bird.
Bye.
That's it. That's what Elmo's thinking about today. Doctors. Oh, is there a doctor in the house?
Did someone call a doctor, sir?
Oh,
what are you doctor.
You know, doctors. Wait a minute. That's not a doctor. That's a doctor. And a quack.
What does a doctor do with it?
Look at that!
He's got a doctor's coat on.
Nice.
Mr. Dr. Noodle!
Wait, what's that in his pocket?
Oh, look! That's a stethoscope!
Now he's got it. A stethoscope. So do your thing, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, what does a doctor do with it?
What's the last?
A dog? What's he gonna do with that dog?
What's he up to?
That's not where it goes.
No, you use a leash to walk a dog, not a stethoscope.
Mr. Noodle, you don't put it on the dog. You put it on you.
Yeah, put the stethoscope on you. Yeah, I have a dog like that.
That's nice, Mr. Noodle. Oh.
Oops. He's okay.
Go ahead. Put the stethoscope on, Mr. Noodle.
Wait, now what's he doing? It's not a tail, Mr. Noodle.
The stethoscope goes in your ears, Mr. Noodle.
Put it in your ears.
Yeah, your ears.
Right, up there. Your ears. Good job. Now he's got it.
The stethoscope helps you hear better.
Ooh, be careful. A doctor uses it to listen to the heart. Whose heart are you gonna listen to, Mr. Noodle? So find somebody.
Mr. Noodle's looking around.
Will he find someone? He's on the move.
Mr. Noodle can listen to Elmo's heart. Go ahead, Mr. Noodle.
No, not there.
No, that's not where Elmo's heart is. It's here, in Elmo's chest. Go ahead, Mr. Noodle.
Right there.
Oh, that's cold.
Oh, he's warming it up. Nice, Mr. Noodle.
Better.
Good job, Mr. Noodle. Sounds good.
Oh, yay! You did it! Way to go, Mr. Noodle!
Now what?
Listen to your own heart.
He found his heartbeat.
Wow! Mr. Noodle's heart is beating with a rhythm.
He's doing his thing. Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-doo-doo-doo. He's got the beat. I like the way Mr. Noodle dances.
Me too.
Mr. Noodle has a lot of heart and soul. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What does a doctor do with a stethoscope?
Don't
Dorothy, a doctor listens to your heartbeat with a stethoscope like this. Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-boom.
And a doctor also uses it to listen to your lungs. Breathe deep, breathe deep, breathe deep. Sounds great.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Emma will listen to a baby's heartbeat. Hi, Sienna. Sienna, where's your heart? Oh, there it is. Okay. Oh, yeah. Wow. Boy, you have a really good heartbeat. Oh, thank you, baby. Boy, you gotta have heart. Oh, and now Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many stethoscopes are dancing in this conga line? Let's count them together and find out.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight!
Ho ho ho! Boy, eight stethoscopes dancing in the conga line! Oh, great counting, everybody.
Elmo has email.
Oh, look. Boy, the computer is playing doctor today.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, thank you, computer. Oh, it's email from Big Bird. Yay!
Hi, Elmo. I'm at the doctor's office. In the waiting room. I'm waiting to see the doctor. Hey, gee. I guess that's why they call this the waiting room. I like waiting because there's so many great toys in this waiting room. Like this doctor kit. Okay, Radar. Now, I'm Dr. Big Bird, and I'm going to examine you now. First, I'll look in your ear. Uh-huh. Fuzzy. Just like they should be.
Big Bird, the doctor will see you now.
The doctor? Oh, the doctor. Gotta go. Bye, Elmo.
Oh, thanks, computer. Boy, that makes Elmo wonder. Who else goes to the doctor? The doctor. Who goes to the doctor and who doesn't? Let's find out. Oh, drawer, open up, please. Oh, come on, drawer. Like the doctor says, open up and say, ah! Do birthday cakes go to the doctor?
No.
But a doctor can have a birthday. Does a baby go to the doctor?
Yes.
A baby doctor?
No.
Not a baby who is a doctor. A doctor for babies and kids. A pediatrician.
Oh, a pediatrician. Do elephants go to the doctor?
Not like that. In a zoo, the animal doctor comes to an elephant.
Does a rock go to the doctor?
No, rocks don't go to doctors.
Unless it's my pet rock, Rocco. Say ah, Rocco.
It's a rock, Zoe. Ah, thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Joe went to the doctor for a checkup. And he told Elmo all about it. You want to watch too, Troy? Okay.
Once a year, I go to the doctor for a checkup. Just to make sure I'm healthy. My mom always comes with me.
Hello.
First, the nurse weighed me. Nurses help doctors.
Good.
Then she measured me.
Turn around.
I grew 2 inches last year. Then the doctor came in. She asked me to take off my shirt so she could examine me. First, she listened to my heart with a stethoscope. Then she listened to my lungs. Didn't hurt, but it was a little cold. Then she looked in my ears. That didn't hurt, but it tickled a little bit. She used something called a tongue depressor to look at my throat. The doctor said to stick up my tongue and say, ah.
Ah.
That didn't hurt either. Then the doctor examined the rest of me. My eyes, my stomach, my knees. None of that hurt either. She said I was very healthy, but I needed a shot so I would stay healthy. That hurt, but only for a minute. And then I got to pick out a sticker. And the exam was over. Mom said she was really proud of me. I was proud of me too.
Aw, Elmo's so proud of Joe too. Now, Elmo wants to learn more about doctors. How can Elmo find out more? Is TV? Is TV sick? Does TV need a doctor?
No.
Oh, Elmo gets it. We can watch the doctor's channel. Turn yourself on, TV.
You're watching the doctor's channel. Just what the doctor ordered. And now, here's Doc Martin. Give it to us straight, Doc.
Hi, Doc Martin here with some doctorly advice. Hit it! You're asking me, Doc, how do I stay strong? Just do the doctor all day long.
Do the doctor.
Do the doctor with me. Your mouth and you won't feel blah. Stick out your tongue and just say ah. Do the doctor. Show me your ears, show me your eyes. Do when the doctor keeps you healthy, gals and guys.
Do the doctor.
Do the doctor with me. Rock around. Your heart go beat, beat, beat.
Do the doctor.
Do the doctor with me. Do the doctor.
Coming up next on the doctor's channel, Doctor No, followed by Doctor Yes.
Thanks, TV. Elmo wants to know even
Hi,
more.
Hi, Elmo.
Hi, Big Bird.
Hi, I'm back from my checkup.
Oh, how did it go, Big Bird?
Well, the doctor says I'm fine and feathered.
Oh, good.
Bye, Elmo.
Bye, Big Bird. Elmo still wants to find out more about doctors. Oh, no. Sorry. Elmo meant doctors. Doctors. Sorry. How can we find out more? Even more? Excuse Elmo.
Want to talk to a doctor?
Oh, sure. What's up, Doc?
Well, for one thing, there are lots of different kinds of doctors.
Really?
Okay, doctors, the monster will see you now. Oh, yes, there they come.
Okay. Hey, hey, hi. I'm an eye doctor.
Yay. I am a foot doctor.
What kind of doctor are you?
He's not a doctor. He's a monkey.
Hey, I'd like a second opinion.
You're a monkey.
Uh-huh. He's my patient. I'm an animal doctor, a veterinarian.
Oh, yeah. Even animals have doctors.
That's right. Dogs, cats, giraffes, whales.
Whoa, look. Dorothy's a man veterinarian underwater. Hmm. Okay, time for your checkup. Open wide and say, ah.
That goldfish has a whale of an imagination.
She sure does. Boy, doctors are great. Oh, Dorothy thinks so, too. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing that doctor song.
Ooh, may we sing along, too?
Sure.
Oh.
Doctors, 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 doctors. Sing along.
Doctors, 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 doctors. Doctors, 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 doctors. Doctors, 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 doctors.
Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye, doctors.
Goodbye.
Upset. When we got there to the vet, my pet started to sweat. Waiting was a dog, plus a chicken and a frog. I said, how do you do? They all said,
we have the flu.
Then a piglet came out with a happy looking snout. And he said to my pet,
there's no need to be upset. Vets make pets feel real well. I was sick, so I can tell that the truth is in the end. Vets are really pet's best friend.
Then that vet saw my pet, and she picked her up and rocked her. And my pet could tell that vet was a very nice pet doctor. The vet said to my pet,
You're all covered with sweat, and your tummy sounds upset. But I'll make you feel well yet.
And before I could get to recite the alphabet, the vet nature, my pet, was as good as pets can get. Every pet at the vet danced a silly minuet, 'cause I guess somehow they knew she would make them feel good too.
All the pets are gonna feel real good, real good. All the pets are gonna feel real good, uh-huh. All the pets are gonna feel real good, real good. All the pets are gonna feel real good. So please don't forget to be sure and tell your pets that they shouldn't get upset when you take them to the vet, to the vet.
Sesame Workshop, the nonprofit educational organization behind Sesame Street and so much more. Learn more at sesameworkshop.org.
SesameStreet.com!
Look for these great products from Sesame Street.
Elmo's so happy to see you!
Join everyone's favorite furry red three-year-old, his goldfish Dorothy, and friend Mr. Noodle in Elmo's World. Now in two new Elmo's World home videos. Elmo's World, The Street We Live On, and Elmo's World, Families, Mail, and Bath Time. What is Elmo thinking about today? Why, it's Sesame Street. It's an unforgettable adventure through Sesame Street's most magical moments. Can you guess what Cookie Monster gets in the mail? Discover the answer to this question and more with Elmo and Friends as they explore families, mail, and bath time. Now you can find out all about anything and everything when you visit Elmo's World on DVD and VHS. Make Elmo's World a part of your world. Collect them all. Only from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder.
Join Elmo in the new video, Elmo Visits the Firehouse. Meet real firefighters and learn about what to do if there's a fire.
What's a firehouse?
Get Elmo Visits the Firehouse today.
Elmo had you get now and now like this.
you're there. Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Don't you go back in.
You're safe now, kitty.
Available only on Sesame Street video and DVD.
Hi. It's musical. It's magical. It's Elmo.
This is going to be fun.
Elmo's Musical Adventure, the story of Peter and the Wolf on VHS and DVD.
Also available, Big Bird in China and Big Bird in Japan. Now for the first time ever on DVD.
Who doesn't have a favorite song?
Everybody does.
If you love kids' favorite songs, then you'll want to join Elmo and his Sesame Street friends for Kids' Favorite Songs, too. Pick your favorite from 15 songs, all guaranteed to get you dancing.
The wheels on the bus go round and round.
Rubber ducky, you're the one.
Plus, there's an extra special bonus, the Sesame Street feature hero guy.
I didn't expect to see that.
Kids' Favorite Songs, too, on video, CD, and cassette. Only from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder.
I love it!
Experience the wonder online at www.sonywonder.com.